Epic Geen here with another epic tutorial for you. Today we're going to go over five different things because there's a lot to go over in this whole thing. So I broke down this tutorial to five different tutorials because I don't want it running an hour long. So we're going to basically going to go over currency. That's this video, how to get currency, how to set it up. Then we'll go over how to build a shop and run a shop with your currency that you have and work with your NPC player. Then we're going to work on how to sell both using your NPC player and having an auto sell system set up. And then we're going to work on basically things that you can add to your world to add currency into what you already have. And then we'll work on how to basically transport your shop so you can build one shop and then mirror all your shops off of that one shop to make things a lot easier for you so you don't have to type things into command blocks every single time, because you know how it is on Bedrock where we have to do it. It's a pain. So we're going to go over that, and everything you're going to need is going to be down in the description so you can jump around at any time while you're building your shops and everything else. All right, let me get set up and we'll get started. Alright guys, here we go. This is going to be the first of five videos, and here we are. We're going to set up your currency for your world. This is very simple. There's a lot of videos out there of how to do this. I'm just going to go ahead and do a tutorial on it so you can kind of keep in tune with everything that I'm going through, because it's going to be a little bit different than what you've seen on YouTube thus far as far as what and how I do it. Okay, so the first commands we're going to learn are, you know, how do you add your scoreboard on your side. You might know that, you might not. Then how to give yourself, now I'm calling my currency stones. You can call it whatever you want. It could be money, dollars, pounds. It doesn't matter. It's whatever you want. And this is just for testing purposes only. And then how to remove it, just in case you want to remove your score and start all over again. Now, the reason I'm using command blocks is because I prefer command blocks over putting in my commands, because I know where they are and I can get rid of them. I need to. Sometimes you put things in command and you forget, or it gets kind of lost in there. Like if I pulled up my command list right now, I probably have stuff in there I totally forgot about. Anyway, so let's go ahead and get this started. So the first one is going to be a chain reaction here. And right there, what that basically did was it added my, not only added my scoreboard, but it also added everything it needed to display what I have on the right-hand side there. And then the next one, if I wanted to, say I wanted to experiment and play around with what I'm calling the stones, that's why I have this button for. And if I wanted to get rid of it, that's what I have that button for. That way, it's completely gone without using the command. It's already in here. First, let's look at how we have this all set up, guys. And this is fairly simple stuff. You can see I have my own little personal chain here. So you can do this any which way you want. You can put these in your command. You don't have to do them with the command blocks. But it's kind of good when you're first learning, guys, to use the command blocks to do this. That way it kind of keeps track. And just in case you forget, you can always go back to that command block and remember, even if you put in the command in the command bar. Okay, so the first one, guys, is going to be adding your scoreboard. Okay, and it's scoreboard objectives. Add and then put in, and a lot of people say put in it after dummy or before. It doesn't really matter, it's still going to put it in there. It's like sometimes on my thing you'll see how I put slash scoreboard whatever, and you don't have to do that in the command blocks, but you'll see, and a lot of times I do, because that's just how to have it from Java or from putting in the command bar itself. Anyway, so anything I have in red except for dummy is my currency. So I'm using for my game stones. That part of it can be whatever you want. And if you want to know how to do, if you don't know how to change your font color, I have a tutorial. You can look at my tutorials. Just go to my playlist, and it's how to turn your signs and all that colored. If you want to know that, just go to that tutorial. Anyway, so that's all you write in there. And then on the next one, you can just put in a scoreboard objectives, set display, sidebar, stones. Now, that's basically the sidebar is this. For PlayStation 4, I gotta push it twice the way I have it set up. So it's on the sidebar. Now I can go in here and change this and put this to list, like so. And this will actually change if I erase this. Oops, there I go. If I go here, I have to do it twice because the way I have it set up. And I messed something up. Oh, you know what I did? It's on my last one. Oh, it's not. Oh, guys, Don't listen to me. Push start on your controller. I totally forgot. I was expecting the sidebar to pop up. You see how it says Epic Eating? It says number one because it keeps your ranking by how much money you have if you want to do that on your server. And this works in multiplayer, guys. If my son was to join me right now, you would see him pop up there as well. And then if I want to give myself 50 stones, there it is. You see the 50 right next to my name? So, and if I clear that out, it'll be gone again. Just like so. So you can do that. You can do sidebar or list, but you can't do under name on PS4 or Bedrock because we don't have that like the Java edition does. So you can just use the list or whatever. So you can do actually multiple things. Like you can keep track of kills, which I'm doing right now, and turning kills into currency and keeping a different kill stat. But that's for a later time. I'll do another tutorial on that. But I'll be using both lists to be able to do stuff like that. And of course, your last one is the scoreboard players at P Stones 0. Now, the only reason I added this one in was just so, because if I take this out, let's say I take this out and we go here. And you see when I click this, I'll click it twice. It added it, but you see how it didn't add the zero. But if I go over here and I hit 50 to get myself, see how it popped up there. But if you want to show that right on the scoreboard, right from the get-go, go ahead and put that in there, and it'll show it from the get-go. It's pretty simple, guys. Like so. There, see, it shows Epic Eden 0 now. Yeah, so if you want to show that right from the get-go. Okay, so that's basically that. And to add stones for practice or whatever, remember, stones is my currency, it's scoreboard players at P Stones. And then the amount that you want to give. Just remember the red part basically in this is just basically what you need to put in. Everything else is, I mean, what you have to put in. And the red is basically what you want. Except for when I put this one in where it says dummy. Because dummy is after my own personal, my print. But you can put stones after dummy. Doesn't matter. All right, and then the last one is just to remove, so you don't have to put this on your command. You can just push scoreboard objectives, remove stones. Now, remember, if you put the colored in there, I'm not 100% sure, but you might have to put the colors in there to remove it. So you'll notice that every time I have stones and everything I do, it's red. Even in my labeling here inside my, if you can see up here to the left-hand side, top, it says add 50, and then it's red. It's everything I did, I made sure I put it in red. Okay, but that's going to do it, guys. That's basically it. Like I said, you can go to my tutorial on how to change your font colors. I believe it's episode 11 in tutorials. Just go to my playlist. You'll see it. And that's going to wrap it up for how to get your currency. Next step is going to be how to set up a shop, meaning your NPC player. Even if you know that, just check out how I set up my shop, and it might help you out with some problems you're having. All right, guys, I'm out of here. I'll see you next video.